Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I bring you greetings from the Sri Lanka Medical Association, which is going to celebrate its 126th year and with an anniversary scientific medical congress from the 9th to the 13th of July 2013. As everybody knows, the main focus of the Sri Lanka Medical Association is on continuing professional development, specifically designed for the ultimate benefit of our patients in the country. Now, towards that end, the highlight of the year's academic activity is the Academic Congress, where we bring together experts not only from the national network but also from the international scenario to bring continuing professional development activities and state-of-the-art information on different aspects of care that we can provide for the patients towards the betterment of their own health. This year is very special because the chief guest for our annual congress is the president of the British Medical Association. Why I say that this is very special is that we have had links with the British Medical Association, and in fact the Sri Lanka Medical Association started life as the Ceylon branch of the British Medical Association way back in 1887. And the president this year of the British Medical Association is in fact a Sri Lankan. He is Professor Sir Sabharathnam Arulkumaran, a world authority on obstetrics and gynecology and women's health, and acclaimed as one of the most famous Sri Lankans. And he has been knighted by Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II for services to medicine, especially in the United Kingdom. So, together with him, we also have several other experts on many other different aspects of general medical practice, which would range from the very basic communication skills, which are going to be handled through pre-Congress workshops, going on to things like sports medicine, non-communicable diseases, and many other different aspects of medical care and health care for the people of our country. Now, what is so interesting about the Sri Lanka Medical Association is that we are the apex medical body of the country, catering to the needs of doctors of all specialties, so that we consider ourselves the umbrella organization, and that also gives us a rather free hand to delve into the very many different intricacies of different fields in medicine, unlike some of the highly specialized colleges which have to deal with one area of medical practice. We are at liberty to go on to a very wide spectrum of activities. And our deliberations this year are focusing really on two themes. One is the main theme of the Congress, which is towards continuing enhancement of safety and quality in healthcare. And the other ancillary theme from this is the control of non-communicable diseases. Now, as everybody is well aware of, the communicable diseases like the infections were the bane of our lives till rather recently. Now, Sri Lanka has forged ahead in a very admirable effort towards continuing the control of these communicable diseases. But the spectrum and the importance of other diseases, especially the non-communicable diseases, like heart diseases, like strokes, like diabetes, obesity, and a whole host of related disorders has raised its ugly head. And these have become major problems for our health setup. So this Congress is going to address quite a lot of these issues, and also not to neglect some of the more important communicable diseases as well. They will be dealing with that kind of very broad outlook on the care that we can provide the patients of our country. And as I said at the start, we believe that continuing professional development will ultimately benefit the populace of our own beautiful island. And what we really want to do is to make sure that the state-of-the-art technology that we can provide and bring to the notice of all our medical practitioners will ultimately result in benefits to the healthcare of the people of this country. And we have selected all these different areas of medicine to have symposia, guest lectures, keynote addresses, and even really a debate. And that will be of interest to at least even some of the others, because the debate on the first day of the main Congress on the 11th as a lunchtime event, the proposal is that individual healthcare workers should be responsible for the care and safety of our patients. Of course, there are the other opposing team which will also try to argue that it's not only the responsibility of the individuals but of the system as well. So these are going to be some of the more interesting things that are going to happen in this what we would generally call an academic extravaganza, where we bring a lot of state-of-the-art technology and information to all healthcare workers. It's not only doctors, allied healthcare workers as well. So we are delighted to welcome all the participants to this Congress, and we expect somewhere around 300 to 400 medical personnel and allied healthcare workers to take part in this Congress. And it is our fervent wish that the ultimate aim and the mission of such an activity of bringing in state-of-the-art information on care of patients would ultimately benefit our patients. Thank you very much for your attention.